My name is Didier Collot. I am professor of physics at University of Cambridge and a professor of physics at ETH Zurich in the Astrophysics Institute.
My name is John Tassoulis and I'm the director of the Institute for Ethics in Artificial Intelligence at the University of Oxford.
I'm Michael Brody. I'm from Harvard University.
Hi, I'm Mark Kuckelberg, professor of philosophy of technology at the University of Vienna.
Hi, I am Professor Wesley Roslin-Smith. I am the director for the Center for the Future of Work based at the University of Pretoria in South Africa.
And it's a very exciting conference because people from many disciplines, technology, business, and education, are talking about the future.
The list of the speakers you have is amazing. The setup is amazing and it's very well organized.
I'm amazed by the quality of speakers. We started off with the Nobel Prize winner. You know, I got to speak. Some people I've been working with or around for years are here. And in the range of fields that we're covering, from astronomy to economics to education, this is the only place in the world where this happens right now. It's unique on the planet.
Conferences like this one are fantastic in bringing together people who wouldn't otherwise interact.
I was really excited to be invited and to see like the really high profile, truly international and interdisciplinary kind of people they have brought here. So I'm really enjoying every single speech because it opens up different horizon. And to do this here in Warsaw also with the young people who are attending is really feels very rewarding.
It's been fantastic. There's been a lot of really interesting views that have been shared, a lot of new insights being brought together, and I think that's attributed to the collection of thought leaders that the school has put together for this Congress.
I have to say, I assisted in some of the lectures yesterday, and the idea to listen to completely new topics for me was very most interesting. I remember the physicist who talked about, you know, the discovery of new planets, and then also the discussion about AI. I thought it's very good to bring together, you know, different streams, different types of researchers to create a common forum where new ideas can be discussed. So I think it's an excellent idea to do it.
I'm so excited about SGMK. I'm so excited about this university because of its entrepreneurial nature. It's combining intellectual pursuit with just incredible willingness to explore, expand, see what's new, see what's possible.
As you probably all know, AI has become worldwide of interest over the past 4 or 5 years. And I can tell you, whoever you are, at whatever age you are, within 5 or 6 years, your life will change as a result.
So I'm so excited about the new postgraduate studies here in strategic foresight and how it applies not just to the technical narrow fields that I deal with, but to the breadth of humanity, the breadth of what's possible. What I love about SGMK is that it takes that 360-degree view of humanity, of the intellect, of the world.
The new program in Foresight, I know, is on the books and is going to be starting soon. I've already had discussions with people at the university about teaching in that program and offering what I can do. I developed a curriculum in Houston many years ago. It's the leading, I like to think, at least a leading Foresight program in the world. And if this university wants to become so, I would love to be a part of the team that creates it.
I'd be very interested to come back and talk to your postgraduate students. I think that's an excellent idea. I really enjoyed talking to some of the students after my lecture today, and I hope to do so again.